Thembi Takeover, 3 to 5pm weekdays only on Massive Metro.
An hour of Thembi Takeover with me, Mbali, Nkosi. I'm here till 5 o'clock with you right here on Massive Metro. Keep tweeting me at Massive Metro, and also remember to use the hashtag Thembi Takeover. We just played Utiningo Pro, which is, people are loving the song, even though it's a classic. And right now in the second hour, I've got Miss Israel in the studio, TT. And you know what? I actually want to find out more about how she actually got into it, how she's the first black Miss Israel, which is something actually very epic. I think it's super epic. How are you, TT?
I am great. How are you?
Oh, listen to that voice. I'm awesome. How are you doing?
I'm great. Thank you for having me here.
Is this your first time in South Africa?
Yes. I'm really enjoying here.
How is it different from where you're from?
Well, basically, it doesn't differ that much, from Israel to here. But here you have like much more nature, green. And I have to say, the food here is great. I swear.
Yeah, I also think the food here is amazing. Yeah, that's why I can't lose weight. It's my big problem that I need to just sort out.
You don't look like what you need. Come on.
Oh, thanks. You're being nice. You're being so nice. So let's talk about you. How did you actually get into pageantry in the first place?
So I literally doesn't plan that. I was like tomboy. I didn't really interesting in that word. But my best friend Noah, she's Yemen, really short girl, and me and her working together like in the street, it's like so funny. She's like, one day tells me, oh my God, you're so pretty, we need to send you up to the Mrs. Rabbiti contest, you're going to win, and I'm going to take the prize, the car.
Oh!
Yeah. She won the car.
Did you give her the car?
There is a story about that. We get the car. We go to get the car when we get the key, and like not me, not her, have drive lesson. So it's like you like dreaming about apple. You get the apple, but you don't have the teeth to eat the apple.
So this is
what happened with that. So my brother get the car, not me, not her.
Oh, because now you have to look after the car. It's the insurance. It's everything.
You need the drive lesson in Israel to drive the car. We didn't have it.
Oh, no.
So we didn't really think about that plan in the end,
Yes. Oh, my goodness. But at least you won it. You can always take it back. I'm like, it's still yours.
Yeah.
I'm like,
You know what? It's not that expensive. Just like Suzuki,
Yeah. So you're like, it's fine. So you give it to your brother.
Yeah.
Okay. So the moment you won Miss Israel, being the first black woman, how did you feel, and how did your community actually feel when that happened?
So for my community, it was like big thing, It was like big thing also for Israel as a country, And then they just say, you put us on the map. They was really proud for me. There is like amazing thing about, I don't want to say black people, like about like community that they're happy for you. That you are their daughter, and like, they win. They feel they're like,
they've also won.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So for them and for me, it was like historic moment. It doesn't only about the fact that I win the Mrs. Rare Beauty contact. It's like historic moment because I put in the map something that doesn't exist before.
Yes.
Black beauty that like, that's black. It's also beautiful. And I start modeling at the same time and be like the first one to be in magazine covers and be like a president of a few companies, faces of a few companies in Israel. So it just changed my life, and it's a historic moment for me. It was really exciting. I was like crying, and then like all my picture for my that moment was so bad.
Only on Massive Metro.